अज्ञानतिम् रादस्या ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रीष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिन् इति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादि पाश्चात्यदेशधारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ओके सो इस्कॉन मैंगलोर वेलकम्स यू टू द चिल्ड्रंस प्रोग्राम डे 8 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अक्षर ब्रह्म योगा, दैट मींस अटेनिंग द सुप्रीम। सो फ्रॉम यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड भक्ति योगा। ओके सो आई टोल्ड Bhagavad Gita is like a sandwich, no? Like two breads and one that fillings in the middle. So middle is Bhakti Yoga. First is Karma Yoga, then Jnana Yoga. Okay? So now we are in the highest form of yoga, which is Bhakti Yoga. And how we can attain the Supreme Krishna, that we will see. Now Arjuna is asking, this Bhagavad Gita is full of question and answer, right? Unless Arjuna asks question, Krishna can't answer. Same way, I don't have to tell you children to ask questions. You have lot of questions. But when we go to adults batch, they have less questions. So if you have no questions after the class, it means two things. Either you understood everything or you didn't understand anything. So it can neither one is possible because nobody can understand whole Krishna, right? He is so vast and nobody can't understand anything also, like something we would have understood. So you should always ask questions, not in a challenging mood, but to know the truth. Okay, now Arjuna is asking, how can those engaged in devotional service know you at the time of death? Daksha Chaitanya, what is devotional service? Means what?
Service to Krishna.
Like service to Krishna, like example?
Chanting.
Yes, very good. Yes, like chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, hearing Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, right? These are all devotional services, means service to Krishna. So if you do the service to Krishna, how can you know Krishna at the time of death? This is what Arjuna is asking. Whatever we think at the time of death, we attain that in the next life. So this is devotional service. Okay, Darsh Chaitanya. That means hearing, chanting, remembering the Lord. Hearing. So we all are hearing Bhagavad Gita for past 7 days we heard. Right? Some of them have been with me for the like 2-3 batches they are with me. Okay, so they are always hearing about Krishna. Now who is this? Parikshit Maharaj is hearing from Shukadev Goswami, Bhagavatam. So hearing. Then chanting. You can chant the Hare Krishna mantra. Who did that? Mirabai, Narad Muni. Okay, they all did chanting. Then Smaranam, remembering the Lord. Like Prahlad Maharaj, Haridas Thakur. So they all used to. So this is devotional service. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam. Like hearing, chanting, remembering the Lord. So these are the services to Krishna. Now, the universe is like a cosmic form of the Lord, and Lord represents the super soul dwelling in everyone's heart. So Krishna is in everyone's heart, right? Sai Ganesh, how is Krishna in our heart as? Anuradha? Anuradha can answer. Yes, Anuradha?
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. So Krishna is in our heart as?
Paramatma.
What is the feature form of Paramatma?
400 form.
400 form. Very nice. Oh, all the children have become champions. Very nice. So, Krishna is in a heart as Paramatma. Paramatma's another name is Super Soul. We are soul. Paramatma is, we are Jivatma or the soul. And Paramatma is Krishna, the Super Soul. So, both are in a heart, right? So, Krishna is in everyone's heart. Now, see the cocoon. You have seen the cocoon. Inside that, there is a small worm. This worm becomes the beautiful butterfly later on, right? You learned this metamorphosis. Now what happens? The worm inside that womb, that cocoon, that shell, will always think, I want to become a butterfly. I want to become a butterfly. So it keeps on thinking. Similarly, the more we do service to Krishna, like chanting, hearing and all, then we can also go back to Krishna. Not like we can become Krishna. Nobody can become God, right? So if somebody says, I am God, then they are faking, right? Nobody can become God except God. So you don't get fooled. Sometimes if someone say, I can become God, you can tell them, go to Vrindavan and lift the Govardhan hill with your pinky finger for 7 days. For the left hand, I will tell them you are God. Or go stand on top of Kaliya, the snake, or any snake and dance. Nobody can do it, right? Except God. So some fake gods will come. Now, yes, Didipya, Sloka.
Yes, Mataji. Anta kale cha mam eva smaranam muktva kale varnam ya prayati sam madbhavanam yatinasti atra samasyaha.
Translation.
And whoever at the time of death quits his body, remembering me alone, at once attains my nature. Of this, there is no doubt.
Yes. So this is what Krishna is saying. No, whoever remembers me at the time of death or when the soul leaves the body, then they will attain that nature. Okay, Charu, you know who this is lying in the bed of arrow?
Yes, Mataji, Bhishma.
Yeah, very good. So Bhishma Dev. Okay, so at the end of Kurukshetra war, when Arjuna aimed put all the arrows, Bhishma fell onto the ground and Arjuna also made a bed of arrows for Bhishma Dev, right? Sometimes it is said life is a bed of thorns, not roses. That means there will be problems in life, not like it's very easy life, but you can convert those thorns to roses by taking Krishna with you, right? So when Krishna is with you, those sharp thorns will become blunt. It won't hurt you. So problems will come, but when Krishna is with you, when problem come, you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Then that problem becomes very easy to cross. So what should we do? We should remember Krishna at the time of death. Then when the soul leaves this body, we can go back to Krishna. So Bhishma Dev was seeing Krishna. He has a boon. What is the boon of Bhishma Dev? Who knows? Dhani Vishrivalli? Shrivalli, you know? Yeah, Pratyusha, what is the boon of Bhishma Dev? Like, he can die? Something about his boon?
Mataji, whenever he want, he can die.
Ah, yes. Whenever he want, he can die. But he waited for Uttarayana. That means the time he want to see Krishna and die. Then he chanted Vishnu Sahasranam. Remember the Vishnu Sahasranam which you sing? Sashanga Chakram Sakirita Kundalam Sapita Vastram Sarasiru Hekshanam Sahara Vakshastala Shobika Stabam Namami Vishnum Sharasa Chaturbhujam. Like 400 Vishnu. So you're praising Vishnu's name. Or he's praising Krishna in different way. 1,000 names of Vishnu he chanted at the time of his death. And finally he went back to Krishna, right? So antakaleshu mameva smaran mukta kalevaram. If you remember Krishna at the time of death, then you can go back to Krishna. Hare Krishna, Danya. When you are preparing for exam, you have to read and write so many things, no?
Yes,
can you go to
Mataji.
Can you go to exam without preparing?
No, Mataji.
And you won't remember, right?
Yes.
Similarly, death is an exam. The final exam we have is called death. At that time, if you have to remember Krishna, you need to practice it now, right? See, when you're going for exam, you need to practice or you need to memorize it or study before going, right? You need to prepare. Even for entrance exam, you need to prepare, then go. Similarly, this life is a preparation for next life. So when the death comes, when the soul leaves the body, if you want to remember Krishna or want to go back to Krishna, you should remember Krishna at the time of death. How is it possible? Not like suddenly one day you remember. Yes, Ajamila's case is an exception. He was a pure devotee and Krishna is showing us that you should become like at least like that, because Ajamila at least got a second chance. We don't know. We get a second chance. So you should start remembering Krishna now itself. How can we remember Krishna? Oh, there are 108 people in the class. Now let us all unmute and chant Krishna's holy name. Okay. If we want to remember Krishna at the time of death, what should we do? We should practice now itself. Not all are muted. Okay. Yeah, this is also another important sloka. Yes, Lokya.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Can you chant?
Yes, Mataji. Yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tyajate ante kale varanam. Tam tam evaite kaunteya sada tad bhava bhavita.
Yes, translation.
Whatever state of being one remembers when he quits his body, that state he will attain without fail.
Yes, so whatever state we remember when we quits our body, what does it mean by quitting the body? That the soul leaves this body and goes to another body, right? What is the 2.13 sloka? Who knows? 2.13. Dehi nosmin. Charu, you know the sloka? Pratisha? 2.13. Yes, Arartrika.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna, what is that sloka, you know?
Mataji, one second.
Sarayu.
Dehi nosmin yata dehi gaurarambam
yajam. Can I chant, Mataji?
Tata deham taprapra.
Dehinosmin yata dehe kaumaram yavanam jara tada dehandara praptir dhirastatra namohyati. So what happens when the soul moves from youthhood to boyhood to adulthood? Same way, at the time of death, the soul leaves one body, takes body, and the person who knows this does not get disturbed. So dehandara prapti, right? So whatever state of my mind it is at the time when we quit the body, that state we will attain without fail. Okay, like the story of Bharat Maharaj. Now this Bharat Maharaj is not that Ramayana Bharat Maharaj, okay, Ramayana Ram's brother Bharat. No, that is different. This is a different person. Now, Bharat Maharaj, I'll tell a story. So he was a king and he had wife, kids, everything. He left all his family members and went to a forest. Now, what happened when he went to the forest? He was doing so much devotions. Okay, every day he used to do yajna, right? Every day he used to offer everything to Krishna, everything, all nicely he was doing devotional service. One day he saw a deer. Okay, this deer was pregnant. It was a female deer, but she was pregnant. And what happened? Bharat Maharaj started patting that deer because it was in the forest, and you know, deers will come, they look cute, but when we go to wildlife and forest and all, they'll run off when they see us. They are scared we hurt them. But those times the deers were very deer. So the deer used to come visit Bharat Maharaj. Bharat Maharaj used to feed him some bananas and all. So they became affectionate, right? When you have a puppy at home, we used to pat it, play with it, right? Then what happens? Every time we'll be with that puppy. But what happens if the puppy die? Then we get disturbed. We are so attached. Similarly, Bharat Maharaj was so attached to this deer. One day, one lion came. It's a forest. Lion came. It started chasing this deer. Then there was a river. You can see a river there near Bharat Maharaj's house. At that time, she was so fearful of the lion, she delivered a baby there. Okay, baby deer was born and she died. The mother died and the baby deer was there. So Bharat Maharaj went and took that baby deer. The lion went off and started. He went to the river and took that baby deer and came back. And he started because he felt so bad for the deer. The deer lost his mother. he started patting, and every day he used to feed that deer and became so close to that deer. He was always thinking about the deer. He forgot his devotional service. He forgot chanting. He forgot everything. It happens, right? When Maya is so strong, it happens like that. We forget. And what happened? When he was about to die, he was thinking, who will take care of this deer? Who will give him food when I die? What to do? And he started thinking of the deer and deer and deer. Finally, he got the life of a deer in his next life. So this is what. And later on, he was so fortunate that he remembered. Then after that, he became Jadabharadan. And then he remembered his past life, why he became a deer. And he went back to Krishna. That is another story. But then, whatever state of mind we think, we attain that. So if you think of Krishna, then you can go back to Krishna, right? So what does Krishna says after that? Yes, Bharka, please read. Therefore, Arjuna.
Yes, Mataji. Arjuna, you should always think of me in the form of Krishna, and at the same time carry out your prescribed duty of fighting with your activities dedicated to me and your mind and intelligence fixed on me. You will attain me without doubt.
Yes, so he is telling to think of him as the form of Krishna. What is the form of Krishna, Risha? How does Krishna look?
Two-handed form.
Yeah, what is his color?
Blue.
Bluish black. Okay, bluish black. Not full blue. It is kind of black, bluish black. Yes. And what does he have in the hand?
He has a flute in his hand and he wears yellow color because he likes that color.
And what else he has in his hair?
He has a peacock feather.
Very nice. Good. So he is telling to always think of him as a form of Krishna. Okay. This is why we are telling how Krishna looks. You should always see a photo of Krishna or some deity and try to remember that form. Okay. You should think of Krishna, God in the form of Krishna. At the same time, carry your prescribed duty of fighting. So as children, your duty is to study. So you should study well, but at the same time, you should think of Krishna as well. And you should carry out your duty. That means that's what you should do. And all your action should be dedicated to Krishna. And your mind and intelligence should be fixed on Krishna. Then you will attain without doubt. Who is this in this picture in the middle? So many times I told about him. Yes, Anjali. Who is this? Story from Bhagavatam.
Mataji.
Who is this?
Dhruv Maharaj.
No, not Dhruv. Another one. There's one more person, no? I'll give a clue. His father was a demon.
Prahlad.
Very nice. Yes. So Prahlad Maharaj, who was Hiranyakashipu's son. So this Prahlad was always thinking of the Lord, right? And he was also doing his duty. He was studying in school. At the same time, his mind and intelligence was fixed on Krishna. Okay, then he attained Krishna, right? He went back to Krishna. So you should begin your devotional service in childhood. Okay, so Darshan Chaitanya told us that devotional service means service to Krishna. What, like what? Example, chanting his holy name, Hare Krishna mantra, then remembering Krishna, right? Kirtanam, singing his songs, hearing Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam. Okay, so who is this small boy? What is happening here? Anybody knows? Sudikshna, you know? Sudiksha, who's the small boy? Neil? There's some Radha Yatra happening.
Yes, Mataji.
Who's that? Yes.
Don't know, Mataji.
Okay, that is Srila Prabhupada, okay, who's our founder Acharya, no? When he was 5 years old, when he was small, he did this Radha Yatra of Jagannath, okay? And he carried Jagannath. Okay, so this is Srila Prabhupada, and he in small, small age only you should start your devotion. So you all are sitting here, all are below 15 years old, right? So you are very young, and except my co-host. So you are all starting your devotional service in your childhood itself. You're so lucky. You ask us, we all came late in this process, okay? And whoever is senior to, in age, whoever is senior to us, they are telling us we are lucky. Like that, we are telling you are lucky. Because at small age, you're able to chant Krishna's name. You're able to memorize slokas. Very nice. The more faster you learn, younger you learn, the more you can remember. Sometimes we can't remember the slokas. We find it difficult, right? In old age especially, they find it difficult. So you should start your devotional service from childhood. Like Prahlad Maharaj says, Kaumare Acharet Pratnye. So this is the mantra we should all chant, right? So this is the Hare Krishna mantra. And who are these dancing here? Who are the ones who gave this mantra? And yes, Shrileka, who are these? They are? You know?
They are?
Who is this? Yes, devotees, but in the who is this? Who came as a devotee 500 years ago? Krishna came as a devotee. Who was that? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So this is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna, and this is Nityananda Prabhu, who is Balaram. So they came as devotees 500 years ago. Why? To propagate this Hare Krishna mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Yes, unmute and sing once. Okay, so this is the Hare Krishna mantra. Okay, so now what does Krishna say after that? Yes, Pratyusha, read it.
Yes, Mataji. He who meditates on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, his mind constantly engaged in remembering me, undecayed from the path, Bharta Arjuna is sure to reach me.
Sorry, I was muted. If you meditate on Krishna with the mind always engaged in remembering Krishna, then Partha Arjuna, right? He is son of Pritha, Kundi Devi. So Partha, they will surely come back to me. This is Ajamila. I already told you, no? Ajamila kept the name of his son as Narayana. He had a very bad life, but at the time of death, when he called Narayana, he called his son. But when Yamadudas came, the Vishnu Dudas also came. Why? Because he called Kriya Vishnu's name. And they had a talk. And this one, Ajamila could hear it, everything. It is there in the sixth canto of Bhagavatam. It's a long story. But then when they talk, they were talking about the holy name of Krishna. That whoever chants it even once, knowing or unknowingly, they get that liberation. So they are in that process of liberation. Not like we can directly go back. No, but something we have done so that we have started the process. Okay, then he was given a second chance. Prabhupada have written a book called Second Chance. It's only about Ajamila. So Ajamila went to Rishikesh and did devotional service. Then went back to Krishna. The same Vishnu Dudas came. See, you can see here Vishnu Dudas are having 400, right? Like Vishnu. So the associates of Vishnu. This is called Sarupya Mukti. there are different types of mukti, sarupya, salokya, samipya, all that. In one is sarupya, you get the same form as the Lord, but you can't become Lord, that is different. So this is another mukti. But a devotee don't want all these. Devotee want to serve Krishna in Golok Vrindavan, right? So Ajamila went back. They will surely reach. So this is what Krishna says. I am not saying it, okay? And in 8.9, it is said, you should meditate upon the Supreme Person as the one who knows everything. He is the maintainer of everything. So Krishna knows everything. Okay, he says, Aham sarvasya prabhavo matta sarvam. Yes, who knows that sloka? Yes, Haripriya, you know that sloka 10.8? Do you know? Yes, Didipya, that sloka.
Mataji, I don't know the second line.
Oh, only one line, you know?
Yeah.
Manaham. Aradhrika, you know? Okay, so it is, yes, Lokya. Lokya, I mean, it's the 10th chapter sloka, so you won't be knowing. My volunteers, some will know.
Mataji, ask for who all are from Bhakti Vriksha class, they all know.
Yeah, that's what I am confused. Yes, Sai Ganesh, you know? Sai Ganesh?
No, Mataji.
Okay, no problem. Yeah. Srileka?
Yes, Mataji.
10.8. No, like many are not here, Mataji. That's why the Bhakti Vriksha students are not come. Okay, so it is Aham Sarvasya Prabhavo Matta Sarvam Pravartade Idi Matva Bhajante Maam Bhuta Bhava Samanvita. So Krishna says, everything comes from me. I am the source of everything. So Krishna is the maintainer of everything. If we know this, we should meditate upon Krishna. See, you can see here now the 200 form of Krishna. He is bluish black color. Jayetu Jayetu Megha Shyama Komalango. You have seen a freshly formed monsoon cloud. It is bluish black. Okay, blackish it is. So that is the color. It's not fully blue. It kind of black also. So that is Krishna. And with a flute and peacock feather. Okay, so you should meditate on Krishna in this two-handed form. This is the two-handed form of Krishna. And who says Krishna is like this? Like he wears a yellow garment, he has a Vaijayanti mala on his chest, and he has a peacock feather and a flute. So who gives the references? So who is God? This is his name. Krishna and Nikhilesh. Nice name. Krishna.
Yes, Mataji.
Who is God?
God is the supreme Godhead.
Yeah, so what is his name?
Lord Krishna.
Krishna. And Krishna means what?
All attractive.
Okay, what is your name?
Miss, my name is only Krishna.
Your name is Krishna. Lord. Wow. Very nicely.
Yes.
Yes. So you should know the meaning of your name, right?
That would be a little hard because my parents every time will be busy when I ask and they will be like,
they don't know. Oh,
they gave my name when I asked because they said I'm too young to understand. I ask them and every year I ask and finally this year because I'm 10 now.
Oh, Krishna means all attractive. So you attract everyone.
I attract my class.
Yeah, so
by my
yeah. So, but our Lord Krishna attracts everyone. See, your name is Krishna. See, your parents would have called you like 100 times every day. No, Krishna, come here. Krishna, eat the food. Krishna, sit here. Krishna, did you do your homework? Krishna, what is happening? Krishna, Krishna. So always at your home, your name will be chanted, Krishna. But they are calling you, but they get the benefit of calling the original Krishna. That's why the parents keep their name as God's name in childhood. they keep the name like that, right? Like Govinda, Gopala, okay, Mukunda, they call like that. Why? Because they indirectly they are calling the Lord, right? Same like Ajamila. So your parents are getting benefited. Not only your parents, Krishna, whoever your friends, whoever calls you, know, hey Krishna, come, let us play. They are actually calling God. Okay. So you're lucky to have this name. Very nice name. Oh, my cousin's daughter's name is Krishna. And she was crying every day. She come back from class and she'll tell, what name my parents gave me. I told, why? What is wrong with your name? Then she told, all my friends are teasing me. What name you have? Their name is Pinky, Tinky, Chinko, Minko and all. Okay. But what is that name? And she started crying. She said, I don't want such a name. I want a new name. Okay. Everybody is teasing me. She didn't know the value. But once I took her to the ISKCON temple and when I showed Krishna to her and I told, this is Krishna, the Lord. He was standing with the flute with Radharani. And she saw that. She started crying. She's just like 7th standard. She's crying. I asked, what happened? Why are you crying? Then I told about who is Krishna. Krishna means all attractive. He's a supreme Lord and he knows everything. He's a supreme father. He's very sweet. I told all this and Krishna is the best name in the whole world you can get. She started crying and she hugged me and she thanked me. She's like, I'm so happy, auntie, because you are the one you made me realize the importance of my name. So this is God, Krishna. Right? So this is the meaning of the name. Krishna means all attractive. Okay? Is he a person? Yes, he is a person. What is his form? The two-handed Shyam Sundar form. So Krishna is God and he is a person. He has a Shyam Sundar form and we should meditate on that form. This you should always by heart and see. If someone comes and tell, I am God, you should tell, no, Krishna is God and he is a person. He is not any energy or light. Okay? And you should meditate on that form. And what is this Krishna's form? What is the reference? Some will ask you, why Krishna can't have four hands? Why Krishna is this color? Why Krishna is wearing yellow garments? Why Krishna is having a flute and a peacock feather? Then you can say, yes, this evidence is from Shastras. So Srimad Bhagavatam says, Barhapitam Nadavaravapu Karnayo Karnikaram Vipratvasa Kanaka Kapisham Vaijayantim Chamala Ran Ran Veno Radhara Sutaya Purain Gopa Vrindair Vrindaranyam Swapadaramanam Prakishat Kita Kirti. I'm not going into the meaning, but this sloka says Krishna has a flute in his hand, Krishna has a Vaijayanti mala, he wears yellowed garments. And what about Brahma Samhita? Venum kanvanta maravinda dayala daksham barhavatamsham ashitam budasundarangam kandarpakoti kamaniya vishesha shopam govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami. So that Govinda, the first purusha, he has a flute in his hand, peacock feather. And Mugundamala stotra also says, what does it say? Jaitu Jaitu Devaki Nanda Suto Jaitu Chaitu Meka Shyamala Komalango. So it gives the color of the Krishna that he is bluish black. Okay. And everybody meditates on Krishna. If you think, oh, what about Shiva? Shiva meditates on the Sangarshan form of the Lord. Shiva is Vaishnavanam Yada Shambho. He is the best among the Vaishnavas. So Shiva meditates on Vishnu form of the Lord. And Brahma also meditate on the Vishnu form of the Lord. Okay. Vishnu is also incarnation of Krishna. Okay. And Vishnu takes kind of all the avatars and Krishna takes the other avatars. He is busy with his pastimes. Okay. I will tell you in Golok Vrindavan chart, like where Krishna stands. Okay. Oh, did Reena Mataji join? I want her to take the Golok Vrindavan. Hare Krishna, Reena Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji, Hare Krishna.
Please keep the Golok Vrindavan chart, that PDF also ready, no Mataji, with the video?
Okay.
Yes. Thank you. Okay, because my PDF is not clear. Okay, so I will tell you where Vishnu is, where Krishna is, where Shiva is, everything will be clear today. Okay, so this is how he will be in the four-handed form and everyone worships that Govinda, who is the Adi Purusha. You can see him, he's so cute. Who can't fall in love with this beautiful boy, Krishna, right? That means that person having a strong heart and a stone heart. Only stone-hearted people won't fall in love with Krishna. Otherwise, everyone Krishna attracts, right? He even attracts the Cupid. That's why he called Madana Mohana. So Krishna means all attractive. He He attracts everyone. And he's a supreme lord. You can see in Vrindavan how the cows, the monkeys, everyone plays with Krishna. He plays with the cow and the boyhood friends. And he steals butter when Yashodamaya. Who knows the story of Sudama and Krishna? Who can tell me? Yes, Haripriya. You know the story of Sudama and Krishna?
Yes.
Tell me.
Sudama was Krishna's classmate.
Yeah, classmate. And then what happened?
One day Krishna was going to the Gurukul.
Your voice is breaking.
Sandipani, his teacher, to Krishna.
We can't hear you.
Mommy, your voice is breaking.
Nandita Mataji, can you hear her?
No, the child's voice is breaking.
Yeah, her voice is breaking. She's telling my voice is breaking. Okay, no problem. Yes, R.R. Trika, you know the story? Sudama.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Yeah.
Sudama was Krishna's classmate. One day they went to a forest with their teacher. Sudama's mother gave a little food for them to eat in the way. So when Sudama was hungry, he ate and he said lies to Krishna that it vanished.
Then
in life, Sudama became very poor. And then one day, Sudama's wife told, go to Krishna, he's your friend. So she took a little poha and gave to Sudama to give Krishna. So Sudama went to Krishna's kingdom. When he went, those soldiers didn't allow Sudama inside. And then when Krishna saw Sudama, Krishna ran and came to hug Sudama. After that, Sudama didn't tell anything. Krishna washed Sudama's legs with his own hands. And then Krishna knew that he brought poha and he said, didn't you bring it to me? Then Sudama told, I brought a little poha. And then when Krishna ate the poha, their house became like a palace.
Very nice. Oh, you're a very good storyteller, huh? I like the story. Very nice. Yeah, only the mistake. I like the story. A very good storyteller. Only mistake is, I'll just repeat it. She's right. Okay, so she told about Sandipani Muni, right? This is the guru of Krishna. So Krishna and Balram went to Sandipani Muni's ashram to learn 64 arts in 64 days. So Krishna knows everything, right? But he went to Sandipani Muni and took a shelter of his guru. He's showing us, even though he's God, he's showing us to go to spiritual life, you need a guru. Okay, we should all take a guru. So Sudama is a Brahmana and they very great friends. And Arartika, the chickpeas which they ate at a forest, that was given by his guru's wife, okay? Sandipani Muni's wife, not Sudama's mother. So Sandipani's wife gave this chickpeas. They told, go to forest, get wood for the firework. That's because when a question was asked, Sudama could not answer. This was the punishment. And the question was asked to Krishna. But Krishna also didn't answer. Krishna knows everything. But since his friend did not answer, he also did not answer. So both got punishment. They went to forest. At that time, it was raining and wind happened. And Sudama ate everything. No, he didn't give it to Krishna. But what happened? Krishna knew this. And Sudama became very poor. He had 27 children. All were fasting and was hungry. So wife told to go to Krishna. She explained all this, right? After that, Krishna washed his legs with his own hands. And finally, what happened? Sudama got the big kingdom back. So like that, a person who accepts the path of devotional service is not bereft of any results derived from the studying of Vedas, performing austere sacrifices, giving charity, pursuing philosophical and fruitive activities. At the end, he reaches the supreme abode. So what is the use of studying Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Atharva Veda, if you don't know Krishna? So you should do devotional service. Chant Hare Krishna every time. Okay. Now, Mataji, you show the video first and then we'll come back. Can you share?
Okay, Mataji.
So we'll see that Sudama story in a cartoon form so that you don't forget it. Volume, Mataji. Okay, you should never forget the story of Sudama. Okay, it's very, very important to know the story of Sudama. Some people like to hear the story of Sudama so much because it gives hope. They think, oh, we can become rich by praying to Krishna, right? It is also true, but that is not the ultimate aim. What happened, Reena Mataji? Are you okay? You having any issue? So today we learned how you should remember Krishna at the time of death or at the time of every day you should remember Krishna. Not only that, okay, at the time. Every time we should remember Krishna. Nandita Mataji, what happened? Can you? Oh, she's back. Your volume is muted, Mataji. You can unmute it. In your screen, it is showing muted.
Reena Mataji?
On the screen.
Under the video, the sound is off. Just below the video only.
Abandoning unprotective cat.
Aishwarya Mataji, we can't hear you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare now? Krishna, yes.
Yeah. So now we saw the Sudama story, right, with Krishna. But before this, what happened? Why did Sudama become poor? Because when they went to Santipani Muni's ashram, Sudama was given a punishment. He could not answer the question of the Santipani Muni. And Krishna also didn't answer because he was his friend. So what happened? They both got punishment. And Santipani Muni gave them punishment to go to the forest, get wood for the fire, for cooking. So Santipani Muni's wife, Guru's wife, gave them some chickpeas to eat. So when they went to the forest, it was night and it started raining. So what happened? They climbed a tree. Sudama sat on the top. Krishna was in below. And because it was cold, Sudama started eating the chickpeas. He ate whatever his was, and also Krishna's he ate. And he lied to Krishna, I don't have anything. Since he did not give to Krishna that day, from that day he was poor. He became very poor. So that was the story how Sudama became poor. So we also should offer to Krishna. We should not eat for ourselves, right? Next chapter, we will learn Patram Pushpam Phalam Toyam. I think that's tomorrow, yeah. So tomorrow, 9th chapter, 26th sloka, we will learn that. Oh yeah, that sloka Didipya knows, right? What is that sloka, Didipya?
Patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhaktya prayaschati tadaham bhakti upahridam asnami prayatatmanah.
What is the meaning?
The one who offers Krishna flower, fruit, leaf or water with love and devotion will attain Krishna.
Yeah, so no, the Krishna will accept it, right? Yes, asnami. Reena Mataji, can you show the Golok Vrindavan chart? You can share, can you?
Yeah, Mataji.
So now we will see where is Krishna, where is Vishnu, where is Shiva? Okay, what is this Golok Vrindavan? What is Vaikuntha? You get confused. Okay, we will learn this. This is what Namanishta Prabhu used to teach us. And he tells us that we should have this idea about the Golok chart. Okay. This is in Bhagavatam. Then we know where Krishna is present. He's where he stays. Where is Vishnu? Okay. Krishna is there everywhere, right? Krishna is in everyone's heart. Krishna is the taste of water, we learned. Krishna is the light of sun, moon. But Krishna is in Golok Vrindavan also, eternally. Okay, we all have to go back to Golok Vrindavan. So first is Golok Vrindavan, topmost. Okay, below that is Vaikuntha. Reena Madhaji, what happened? We can't see.
Mataji, you cannot see. I have shared it actually.
Can you see Nandita Mataji?
No, Reena Mataji, have you done share screen?
Yeah, yeah, Mataji.
Can you just...
Yeah, I can see.
Yes.
Yeah, one second I will try, Mataji.
Sure, sure. We are just seeing you trying to open that chart. So I thought maybe you should say share screen and then open it. Like you did it last time, the same chart. Thank you. We can see it,
Madhu. Yes. So can you go down? I'll start from Earth. Yes, yes. Little zoom. Zoom in. Yeah, very good. Okay. So now you can see here on the 7th. Madhuji, can you keep the cursor there? On the 7th is Bhurloka or Earth. Okay, you can see there. So that is Earth. Now we are there in human beings and we are there. Okay, we are in this Earth. Now below the Earth, you can see Atala, Vitala, Sutala, Talatala, Mahatala, Rasatala, Patala. So these are the hellish planets, Patala. Okay, and that is coming from the navel of Garbhodakshayi Vishnu. Now that you don't remember. Now you just know we are in the 7th planet. Okay, we are on the Earth. Now above us we have Bhuvar, Samaharloka, Janaloka, Tapaloka and Satyaloka. And then Brahma, Brahmaloka. So these are the heavenly planets. Okay, so middle is the Earth, above is heaven, below is hell. Now Brahma is in Brahmaloka. Now after that, okay, go up Mataji. Then we will see there is another place where all the Devi Devadas are present. Up, up. We can see Maya Devi here. Okay, so here you can see Sadashiva. Shiva is here. Okay, about this earth. Yes, so this is Sadashiva Loka, you can see, right? And Mahakadam. So this is the place where there is Maya Devi, Shambhu, all these are present. And there is a Viraja river. And above that is Brahma Jyoti. Okay, and above that we will see. Yes, Mataji, some more up. So all the Devi Devatas are above these. And then above them you have the Vaikuntha. This blue thing which you see, no? This is Vaikuntha. Okay. In this Vaikuntha, there are... Okay, this is Vaikuntha. There are the 400 Vishnus. All the Vishnus. Different universes are there. Okay, in this Vaikuntha. Okay. And above that is Golok Vrindavan. Yes, Mataji, the topmost. You can show the top. So Vishnu is here and what happens? This pink one is Golok Vrindavan. Now in this Golok Vrindavan, you can see Radha Krishna, right? And you have eight sakis, you can see Lalita, Vishaka, Suchita, Induleka, all these are the eight sakis. And after them, you have Radhi Manjari, Rupa Manjari, all the Manjaris. So this is Golok Vrindavan where Krishna eternally resides. Come down, Mataji. So Krishna's first expansion is Balram. Okay. So Krishna expands as Balram. You can see here. Little up. Yeah. So above that, you can see. Above. Some more up. Near the end of Goloka, I want to see. Some more up. Yes, some more. After Ayodhya, you have. Okay. Yes. So here you can see Krishna is expanding as Balram. So this is Mathura, then Jagannath Puri, Dwaraka, and Ayodhya, where Ram is present. Right? So after all these, that is after Golok Vrindavan, it's Mathura, then Mathura, Jagannath Puri, Dwaraka, then you have Ayodhya. You can see that Ayodhya, that is Ram is there. Now below that, you can see the four first chaturs, that is who? Sankarshan, Aniruddha, Pratyumna, okay, all comes in this Vaikuntha part. Okay, so below this is Vishnu. You can see all the Vishnus we saw. Okay, three Vishnus. Karanodayashayi Vishnu, Kshirodayashayi Vishnu, Garbhodayashayi Vishnu, all are present. Now you understood? This is the chart. Okay, so Krishna is the above. Krishna is the topmost. And four Chaturvyuhas are there. Okay, you can see. And then all this river, and then we are here. And Garbhodayashayi Ocean, you have Garbhodayashayi Vishnu. Okay. So three Vishnus are there. This is Karanodayashayi Vishnu. Yeah. So this is the Golok chart. Okay, Mataji, thank you. So this is what you should know. Now there won't be a confusion. We don't know this. That's why we have... If possible, and Reena Mataji also, please travel if you can. Okay, okay, children, Mataji. Go to the breakout room. Yeah, go to the breakout room. 10 minutes. We will take questions. And whoever is here, you can ask me question. Raise your hand.
We can stop recording, Aishwarya Mataji.
Yes. Stop.